Whether it's 3 or 300, we bring it here every Friday night. The first week of October, and Prep Mania just heating up. Big 8 conference played yesterday, but Friday night is where high school football belongs. Beginning with our game of the week, DeForest coming off a big win against Mount Horeb Barneveld, taking on traditional power Waunakee. First half, DeForest ball. Not anymore. Fumbled snap, Waunakee recovers on the Norski 18. The very next play, Troy Loffenberg has been a beast all season, and it continues on this run. Taking it to the house, 7-0 Warriors. Third quarter, DeForest answers. Connor True to Jake Capstrand. Capstrand, end zone, 7-7. Fourth quarter, same connection, having deja vu. True. Capstrand over the middle, the catch, the score. 14-7 Norskies, that was the final score. Both teams now 5-2. News 3's Jay Wilson has the postgame.
DeForest gets a couple of touchdown passes in the second half. The defense holds on, 14-7 the final, and Jay Capstrand got both touchdown passes, kicked both extra points. You're responsible for all the points there, but you guys don't throw all that much. How are you able to get two touchdown receptions in the second half?
You know, we've been working on it in practice. We've been just working our working hard. We've been doing our thing, and then come away with some big wins like that. We knew Waunakee was going to play man on, so we decided we were going to throw more this game.
Yeah, and I don't know how much of a chance you get to watch your defense play, but talk about that side of the ball and what they've done the last 4 weeks.
You know, it's really been incredible what they've been doing. They've been stopping the run. They've been having good pass defense. I mean, we've just been playing good DeForest football.
Yeah, and after a 1-2 start, this team's on a roll. Must be a pretty good feeling to have such great confidence these days.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, all right, we'll keep it going, and you're still in that race for the conference title. Yeah. DeForest beats Waunakee tonight, 14-7.
Jay, thank you very much. Oh, get some hot cocoa for that young lady. Mount Horeb Barneveld trying to rebound from that loss against DeForest. Taking on Reedsburg, first half. Quarterback Max Myler, keeper, end zone, touchdown, 12-6 Vikings. Getting it done on defense as well. Always be alert, because you never know. Whoop! The ball's coming right to you. Chris Jepsen loses it. Vikings take over. The Vikings take over down the stretch to hold on for a close one. 24-21, the final in week 7. More Badger Conference action. Fort Atkinson taking on Monona Grove, first half. MG's Steven Martini makes it look easy to the right side. Silver Eagles, 7-0 lead later on. MG going aerial. Martini, Trey Powers alone. 13-0 Monona Grove, and Monona Grove can play some D. How about some Powers thievery? Catches on offense, catches on defense, and he's gonna house the interception for a touchdown. Trust me, the bench should be celebrating. Final score, Monona Grove 39, Fort Atkinson 7. Other scores from around the Badger Conference. Monroe taking on Edgewood in the Crusaders' roll, 40-27 over the Cheesemakers. Milton beats up on Portage, 42-0. In the Capital South Conference, there's a big matchup tonight. Undefeated Marshall travels to 5-1 Cambridge in a matchup that could decide the conference. To Cambridge we go in a defensive struggle. First quarter after a Marshall pick, knocking on the door, Adam Acosta stretches. Cardinals take a 7-0 lead, but Cambridge on the comeback. John Garluski fires to a wide-open JT Parrish. That's a 6-pack of points. Extra point makes it 7-7 at half. Third quarter, 10-7 Cambridge. Blue Jays with the ball. Looks like a screen, but wait. Garluski, Houdini, keeps it. Weaves his way through some traffic. He's going to go la distance for the score. Cambridge wins 17-10 in the Week 7 final over Marshall. In the Badger North, undefeated Poinette travels to Lakeside Lutheran. And Poinette trying to stay undefeated. First half, Jake Redeman in the corner for the Puma touchdown. 9-0 Poinette. Couple of drives later, Tanner Brooks rolls out, finds Riley Lytle. The catch, trying to stay in bounds. And that would set up a handoff to Redeman. Again for the score. 15-0 at that point, and Poinette cruises 37-6, the final over Lakeside Lutheran. Other CAP conference action from tonight. Waterloo takes care of New Glarus. Monticello 21-14. Lake Mills and Lodi are rolling. Blue Devils win it 42-14. 22-7. Cuba City still undefeated in 2014, but could they stay that way? That's why I'm here, standing in the way of a 7-0 start, 5-1 Darlington. Darlington has upset on the mind. First quarter, Miles Leahy. Touchdown action, rolls in for the score, making it 8-0 Redbirds. Second quarter, Darlington with the ball again. The reverse. Oh, the trickeration. Jason Singer gallops home for a 14-0 Darlington lead, and right before half, Preston Dressler back to pass. Jason Singer giveth, and Jason Singer taketh away. The interception, Darlington cruises to a 34-7 win. The Redbirds improve to 6-1. Other scores from around the area. Fenimore handles Boscobel, 32-6 the final. And Platteville squeaks by River Valley, 26-20.